I'm announcing today, I'm putting my ass on the line. I'm telling you, there is a black swan event coming. A black swan event coming. I don't know if we're going to war with Putin. I don't know if another coronavirus is going to come out that is not curable. I don't know whether the Federal Reserve is going to finally implode. I don't know what it is, but it's coming. Because every massive bull market needs to find an excuse to correct. And even though we had a recession that only lasted 70 days or 80 days or whatever it was last year, the market is way, 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 way overvalued. Excuse me. And the big smart money, if you follow it, which you don't, 95% of them have all taken money off the table. In other words, taking a lot of profits.
Was caught up in a belief that housing prices could not fall dramatically. Freddie Mac believed it, Fannie Mae believed it, Congress believed it, the media believed it, I believed it.
Wasn't the role of the rating agencies, though, to be referees in a game that got out of control? You told our staff that, well, gee, if they had not done the ratings, they would have been howled at by Congress. But don't we expect referees to make the call?
Yeah,
even if they're going to get booed?
Yeah, and they made the wrong call. I mean, they basically believed, as most of the American public did, and you couldn't have had this size bubble without overwhelming. And the Cassandras were there, but who was going to listen to John Paulson in 2005 or 2006 or Michael Burry? I mean, it didn't mean anything. And, look at me. I mean, I was wrong on it, too. I recognized that something pretty dramatic was going on in housing, but I actually called it in the annual meeting when I got a question on it, a bubblet. Well, that was a terrible term to use. It was a four-star bubble.
Welcome to the Crypto Teacher. And guys, you know, I come back with that video just to make you think. And we know that Black Swan is definitely coming. But we know it's all orchestrated, just like all stock market crashes. We have Charlie Munger and Warren Buffett on CNBC speaking about other companies and other fraud, the banks, but we know they're all a part of it. Remember what Moody's did, rated the F paper as A paper. They were colluding with Goldman Sachs and the rest of the banks. And because your media is controlled, they're never held accountable. Warren Buffett is going to go down as a legend. If you ever done any research on Berkshire Hathaway, and please do your research on all the shell companies they created so therefore they could get around taxes, and that's how it became a behemoth, then you'll understand. Warren Buffett and Charlie Munger know the New World Order's plan to bring in this fourth industrial revolution. Blockchain, cryptos, robots, algorithms. But they have to play their part. The Hegelian dialectic is how you move forward. Because we know, when it comes to the New World Order, it's all planned out. Y'all have a wonderful day.
Of course, if you're running a gambling parlor, you want the big players to gamble more furiously. And that's what the securities business allowed people to do. It was a big mistake. It created a lot of misery. We don't want to suck people into gambling really more than they can afford. And, of course, it was the lure of the really easy money that the idiot was paying you, being the prime broker for a jerk. But he was a convicted insider trader that came out of the craziest part of the hedge fund industry. And they were getting unusual profits by extending unusual credit. I mean, it was just... the world was shouting at them, crook, fool, and they didn't listen. They thought, this is where the easy money is, crooks and fools.
There's one rule
we don't like either.
We learned a long time ago, is that you can't make a good deal with a bad person. Just forget it. Now, if you think you can drop a contract that is going to work against a bad person, they're going to win. For one thing, they probably enjoy litigation, but... Berkshire Hathaway as an entity, or me personally, or anything, we don't want to spend our life, you know, doing that sort of thing. And besides, the bad guys win. They know more games. They may lose eventually in the way, but it's no way to spend your life.
But the banking system take shadow banking, which we have in this country. People say, well, it's the unbanked. Well, the whole leverage buyout lending operation practically left the banks and went to shadow banks in our own country. And it hasn't caused any big trouble yet, but I'll be amazed if it doesn't.
Well, Jamie Dimon has said that, like, look out for some of the fintech areas that they're.
Yes, I agree with Jamie Dimon on that. I don't think allowing all the swingers in the world to act as though they're banks is a good idea.
Which maybe we should talk about Robinhood and some of the areas that come up.
Robinhood is beneath contempt.
Why?
Well, it's a gambling parlor masquerading as a respectable business.
And the pushback on that is always, this is a way of getting average people into the markets.
Well,
people
of who course you don't want to say it's a gambling parlor, but it is a gambling parlor.
It's not encouraging people to buy a very, very, very low-cost index fund and hold it for 50 years. I will guarantee you that you will not walk in there, get that advice. No. Instead, you'll get advice on how you can trade options and they'll tell you that.
And it's telling people they aren't paying commissions when the commissions are simply disguised in the trading. It's basically a sleazy, disreputable.
We're going to a different economy, and we're going to be learning more about that as we go. But clearly, we're learning that things can be done from remote locations. We're learning that technology can replace people even more than we thought.
We're not going back to the same economy. We're recovering, but to a different economy, and it'll be one that is more leveraged to technology. And I worry that that is going to make it even more difficult than it was for many workers.
In Silicon Valley, and my friends who work in technology know that what we did to the manufacturing workers, we are now going to do to the retail workers, the call center workers, the fast food workers, the truck drivers, and then even bookkeepers, accountants, insurance agents, lawyers, and on through the economy. So what happened to the manufacturing workers is a very clear sign.
This effort, and China has big plans for this. They intend to seed their digital yuan into the global environment by giving it away to visitors at next winter's Olympics. When they arrive at the airport, they're going to get yuan digital wallets. They're going to receive digital yuan. They're going to use it throughout their visits to Beijing, and then they're going to take it back to their home countries. They see this as a huge advantage. Why? Because who controls the underlying protocols, who controls the underlying standards of the future of money will control the future of money.
Uber, Bitcoin, self-driving cars. Combine those three together and you have the self-owning taxi. A car that is a corporation that owns itself, pays for the car lease, the car insurance, and the gasoline from the revenues it makes giving passengers a ride, and there's not a single human involved in that matter.